How's everybody doing today?
Good.
So we're going to start with a prayer list. The prayer list, Mac Bowen, Tent Revival, Ted Weaver, Pastor Will Weaver, Evangelist Calvin Weaver. Here are the announcements. Madison Fairground, Tent Revival at Madison Fairground, June the 18th through the 21st, and then Andrews, North Carolina, August 31st through September 3rd. And then we're working on Augusta and Covington, and then we're working on that for Tent Revival. And then, so y'all just need much prayer for that. So, let's run out and pray for those things. Lord, we ask you for thank you for gathering us here today, Lord. Thank you for all for the Tent Revival.
Amen.
So, thank you for that. So now we're going to do some songs.
I came up out of the water. Raise my hands up to the Father. Gave it all to him that day, felt anew and kissed my face. Walked away, eyes wide open, could finally see where I was going. It didn't matter where I'd been, I'm not the same man I was then. Track, I made mistakes, backslid my way into that place where souls get lost, lines get crossed, and the pain won't go away. I hit my knees, now here I stand, there I was, now here I am. That I could take it all back. I just want to tell a man. Tell a man. Go track, I made mistakes. Backslid my way to that place where souls get lost, lines get crossed, and the pain won't go away. I hit my knees, now here I stand. There I was, now here I am.
since it's called Didn't You Die, I'm preaching at the end of the Bible. So I'm preaching like right where, like John 15:13. So, and if you want to hear some of that, if you don't want to hear some of that, you can go ahead out, because if you don't want to hear none of that, I'm going to preach for about 2 hours. Y'all can go ahead out. So, and Jesus arrested from Matthew 26 to Mark 14. Jesus and his three closest friends, Peter, James, and John, went outside after supper to a garden near some olive trees. Stars shone brightly in the sky, and the air smelled sweet. Only he knew that the sun soon the world would change forever. Wait here, Jesus told his disciples. He went alone to the garden to pray for Father. Please, he said, isn't there another way without so much suffering? I don't want to be separated, but Father, I will do what you want. There was no other way. Jesus knew that God would have to lay all the sins of his children on Jesus' shoulders to have him stem from their punishment, and for those hours while Jesus suffered, he would be separated from the Father. He loved the sin and no place with.
Amen.
God, that would be the worst, but Jesus would do it to save men and women, boys and girls from God's judgment. Then he heard the clanging of the soldiers' swords and smelled their torches burning. They plunged into the garden with Judas leading them. Judas showed the guard which then was Jesus.
Right.
And then it says in John 15:13, there is no greater love than this that man should lay down his life for his friends. I love you with a love that never ends. I love you before you were born, and I will continue to love you forever. On the dark night, as so long ago I allowed myself to be killed on a cross because of my unstoppable love for you. Whenever you feel alone or afraid, say it out loud. Say it out loud. Jesus, you are always with me, and you will never stop loving me.
Right.
And this is when Peter denies Jesus. And if you had your Bibles, you would turn from Luke 20. This comes from Luke 22. Soldiers dragged Jesus through the streets to Jerusalem's leaders. Are you the Son of God? They asked. I am Jesus, Jesus said. Liar, they shouted. How dare you discredit God by saying you are his son? Soldiers whipped him and beat him, spit on him. They made him wear a purple robe and a crown of sharp thorns, and they made fun of him. Now you look like a king of Jews, they said. And they laughed while saying. But Jesus had nothing or anything wrong, and he knew it. This was all a part of God's plan. When the soldiers came, some of Jesus' disciples were afraid and ran away. Others, like Peter, hung around to hear what was happening. So you hear how others ran around.
Right.
There's like two or three Bible readers in here.
That's right.
So you see how they hang around? That's what we do. We hang around.
Amen.
What we need to do the only person we need to be hanging out with is God.
That's right.
So Peter was warming himself by a fire when a servant girl asked him, Are you one of those guys who was with Jesus? No, Peter said. It wasn't me. Another girl asked, are you sure? You look like him. It wasn't me, Peter said. More people came up when were sure that guy I'd be not Peter like. I've never known Jesus. Then the rooster crowed, cock-a-coo, and Peter ran away and cried. Now here is this chapter is called Good Friday. From Matthew's 27th, Mark 15th, Luke 23:19. People didn't understand Jesus was God's perfect son, sent him earth to save them from their sins. The leaders brought him to the Roman governor who put Jesus on a trial. Many people were against him. Crucify him, the crowd shouted. Kill him, nail his hands and feet to a big wooden cross. Jesus didn't deserve this. He had spent his time on earth loving and having and telling them the right way to live so they could one day join him there. Dying on a cross like a criminal was a sad but very important part of God's big plan. And Jesus would do not do it. He wasn't a criminal, but he would die like one. The soldiers built a heavy wooden cross and nailed a sign to it that said, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of Jews. Then they marched Jesus through the trees. They made him go up a hill to the place called the Skull. And then they nailed Jesus to the cross. They also crucified him, two criminals with him, one on his right hand and one on his left. At noon, angry dark clouds filled the sky and hid the sun. Powerful lightning and thunder jerked across the sky. God's mighty anger at sin came down. The earth shook fiercely. Huge rocks shattered and split. The sky swirled with dark, scary colors. Father, I give you my life, Jesus said. Then he looked up toward heaven, cried out, it is finished, and he died. And it was finished. Jesus had done it. He had taken on himself God the Father's anger and punishment that was meant for his children to save us from sin. And then John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Yes, I died for you, but don't be sad. Be happy that I love you so much and I want to be with you my very minute, every day, forever. If you ask me to be your savior, we'll be together in heaven someday because I died for your sins.
That's right.
That's right.
But then, didn't he die? Right early Sunday morning. And if you think this ain't true, most people think this ain't picture to see if you think it is true or you think it isn't true. You know him, don't you? And this is from Matthew 27-28, Luke 24. God's big plan wasn't done yet. Some people still doubted that Jesus was God's son. Even his friends weren't sure. You see, Jesus had told people that 3 days after he died, he would live again. Jesus' friends laid his body in a tomb. The Roman soldiers came and sealed the tomb shut with a huge stone so no one could get in to take Jesus' body. They guarded the tomb night and day. Those who hated Jesus figured he was dead and this was the end. Those who loved Jesus were almost afraid to hope. Early Sunday morning, women who were friends of Jesus arrived at the tomb. Suddenly the earth rumbled and shook, a blinding bright light tumbled from heaven, and the angel away from the tomb and sat on it. The sight of the angel and the empty tomb scared the guards so much that they fainted. "Are you looking for Jesus?" the angel asked the woman. He's not here. God brought him to life just as Jesus said he would. Hurry, tell his disciples that Jesus, he is risen from the dead. The woman ran and told the disciples, but the disciples said, "Nonsense." That they sat around looking for sad, refusing to believe that Jesus was alive. Later that day, two of them were walking to a village called Emmaus when a stranger came and walked along with him. What are you discussing?" he asked. "What everyone is talking about," one of his disciples answered. "Have you not been here the past 3 days?" Then they told the whole story of what happened to Jesus. After the stranger heard he said, "Where are you so slow to believe?" He reminded them of everything the prophets had written, everything about Jesus, and especially the part where Jesus would come back to life. When they got to Emmaus, the disciples invited the man to have supper with. He sat at the table, took some bread, blessed it, and broke it. Then he passed it to them. They knew him. "Lord Jesus," then cried out, "it's you." Then suddenly Jesus disappeared. They found the other disciples and told Jesus what had happened. In Luke 24-6, "Jesus is not here. He has arisen. My power is stronger than death. I rose from the dead. I became alive. If you believe in me and ask me to come into your heart, heaven is your future home, and you will live with me forever, even when your life on earth is over. This is the best gift anyone could ever give you."
Amen.
Amen.
So, if you believe that tonight, say amen.
Amen. Amen.
So, what that message is really about is if you know that Jesus died, if you've accepted him in your heart, and you know who Jesus is.
That's right.
So, if you believe that Jesus died, you're already saved. And if you know Jesus, then you're already saved. And if you believe that he died, then you're already saved. So all three of them mean you're already saved. But But to believe that, you can't just say you believe it and not get saved. You gotta get saved to believe it. So, with every head bowed and every eyes closed, say this prayer. Lord, I know I'm a sinner. And I believe what you done on Calvary's Hill. I want you to accept me in your heart. Because I believe you've been knocking on my door for a long time, Lord. And I want you to come into my heart today. And if you just said that prayer, would you just lift up your hand? So, there's one person. I know who I'm talking to right now. It's Tina and Frankie. So y'all are gonna be surprised who just got saved. So, Mom, bring Mom up here. So, he's pretty happy right now.
Happy.
So, Mom, you can come back up here and get him. So, say amen if you enjoyed this service.
Amen.
So, I'm gonna lead y'all in prayer and then y'all can go. Lord, thank you for this day, and thank you for all the blessings you have gave us, Lord. And we pray for the tent revival and what we're doing, and what we're trying to do in Augusta, Lord. And we pray for the Andrews, North Carolina, will be good too, Lord. And we ask for all the praise, honor, and glory, Lord. May it be your will and your way. For this, thank you for the service and the church. In Lord's name, pray, and all of us, and said, amen.
Amen.
Everyone is blessed.